he able to be so effective last night?
Well, the bottom line is he was getting the ball close to the basket. He did a great job of getting himself in position. I think anytime you play against the Phoenix Suns, teams want to do a couple of things against us. They want us to take the ball out of the nets, and they want to try to pound us on the offensive rebound. And Kwame Brown did a good job of getting position down low, converting a couple of shots. He even hurt his ankle on the play, came back Willis Reed-esque as he caught a couple of slam dunks right after he returned from injury. And he just had a great game. The Lakers hold serve, and game four is going to be huge to see if the Suns can come out and go up 3-1.
All right, in the other game last night in the West, Jazz hold the Rockets to just 67 points. Only four players scored for Houston. How were the Jazz able to do that?
The Jazz are a great team. Once you go up in Utah and Jerry Sloan is kind of like that maintenance man in the building that you can't get around because he finds a way to get his team to fight hard. Carlos Boozer really showed up big. They still have to get Memorial Court to play at a top-notch level if they're going to find a way to advance past Houston Rockets and only have four players score. That's an NBA record, as well as to have 67 points like the Rockets did on the road. That's really not going to cut it, but everybody knew coming into this series this was probably going to be a long, drawn-out series, and it's holding up the form so far.
Well, you know, T-Mac and Yao, they're always going to get their points. So what does Utah need to do to tie this series up?
Utah has to do exactly what they did yesterday. They got to get a lot of Carlos Boozer. I think anytime you have Yao Ming checking Carlos Boozer, he has to take him away from the basket, knock down his perimeter shots, his 15, 18-footers, continue to run the floor and finish around the basket when he gets opportunities. Darren Williams has to continue to run the show and find a way to get Andre Kirilenko involved. He's one of the top defenders in the league the last couple of seasons. His confidence and things have been shaken. So if they can find a way to get him to play well, I see this series go 6 or 7 games. But I got a stat for you. 182-11. That's for teams in best of seven series. They got out to a 2-0 lead. 182 wins, 11 losses. So Houston Rockets fans, you still have hope.
And here's a stat for you, too, Jalen. The Jazz have never come back from an 0-2 deficit. All right, moving on.
182-11.
There you go. There's the number. In the East, the Pistons are on the verge of sweeping the Magic. What's been the biggest difference in this year's team?
Detroit Pistons, they're a professional team. That's the bottom line. Anytime you have a team down 2-0 and you go to Orlando and you find a way to get that third game, it really says a lot about your team and its fortitude and finding a way to get the series over with because you have bigger and better plans to try to continue to play in this playoff. And Chris Webber's been a great addition. He had a great game yesterday. My former college buddy and longtime friend. Chauncey Billups, he's always big around playoff time. Rip Hamilton is probably one of the best in the league and coming off baseline screens. And they're really a complete team. Tayshaun Prince is stepping up his game. Along with the Phoenix Suns, I think the Detroit Pistons have the best starting five in the league.
Jalen Rose, thanks for the insight. Best of luck and enjoy the rest of the series.
Thank you very much. And I am a Detroit native, too. Go Detroit Lions. Draft day tomorrow. Let's go, Lions.
Who are they taking with the number two pick?
Probably Brady Quinn or Calvin Johnson.
Either one would be great addition to that team.
We hope so.
All right, Jalen, thanks.
Thank you very much.
All right, still to come on Cold Pizza.